पॉइंट मास इज शॉट वर्टिकली अप फ्रॉम ग्राउंड लेवल विद अ वेलोसिटी ऑफ 4 मीटर पर सेकेंड एट टाइम टी इज इक्वल टू जीरो. इट लूजेस 20% ऑफ इट्स इम्पैक्ट वेलोसिटी आफ्टर ईच कोलिजन विद द ग्राउंड. अज्यूमिंग दैट द एक्सेलरेशन ड्यू टू ग्रेविटी इज 10 मीटर पर सेकेंड स्क्वायर एंड दैट एयर रेजिस्टेंस इज नेग्लिजिबल, द मास स्टॉप्स बाउंसिंग एंड कम्स टू कंप्लीट रेस्ट ऑन द ग्राउंड आफ्टर अ टोटल टाइम इन सेकेंड्स ऑफ. सो वी नीड टू फाइंड द टाइम आफ्टर विच द बाउंसिंग बॉल विल कम टू रेस्ट. यू माइट बी फैमिलियर विद दीज टाइप ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स एंड यू माइट हैव सॉल्व दीज टाइप ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स इन योर जूनियर कॉलेज. लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड दिस प्रॉब्लम विद द हेल्प ऑफ अ सूटेबल डायग्राम. इन द प्रॉब्लम इट्स गिवन अ पॉइंट मास एंड इट इज शॉट वर्टिकली अप. लेट यू बी द इनिशियल वेलोसिटी ऑफ दिस बॉल. And initially, this ball is on the ground. It is shot from the ground level. And the value of u is 4 meter per second. So under this given situation, the ball will go up. And it will reach the maximum distance where the final velocity of the ball will become 0. Okay, so the velocity at this point will be 0. Let's say this be point B. And at ground, let's say its starting point, point A. After reaching the maximum height, the ball will start to fall back. Okay, so when, now let's draw a separate diagram for that. The ball, when it starts to fall back, now when the ball hits the ground, what happens? Its rebounce velocity is decreased by 20%. That means its rebounce velocity will be 0.8 times the previous velocity. Okay, so if I say this ball is going up after collision, let's say this is point C, so this velocity will be u will be equal to, let's say u2 will be equal to 0.8 times of u1. Okay, and this, the initial velocity, the first velocity is u1. So similarly, this will keep happening with the ball. Right, so in the next condition, what will happen when the ball collides with the ground, let's say this be point D, again it will go up with the velocity, let's say u3, and this will be equal to 0.8 times u2. From this pattern, we can see that always the velocity after each collision, so let's write ui plus 1, I stands for number of collisions, will be equal to 0.8 times the velocity in previous collision. So this is the relation of velocity of next collision with the previous collision. Also, if we calculate the time of flight of each collision, that means when the ball is shot from point A, it reaches B, the maximum height, and returns to point A, so total time taken will be time taken to go up, so 2 times of TAB, okay, because it has to go up and it has to come down as well. So in both cases, it will take equal amount of time because we have to neglect all the other factors. So let's write here, time to go up, time up should be equal to time down. Now using equation of motion, we know that final velocity is equal to initial velocity plus acceleration into time. Now in this case, acceleration is acceleration due to gravity, and v is the final velocity, which is 0. When the ball reaches point B, the final velocity is 0. So from here we can calculate t. So from here t will be equal to negative u upon g, acceleration due to gravity. Now acceleration due to gravity acts in the opposite direction. So we can write u is by g because g is negative here. Therefore, we can write the total time of flight. So total time of flight will be equal to 2 times the time to go up. So 2 times of t. So 2 into u by g. Okay. So for first collision, let's say if this is time TAB, or if I say this is T1 here, time taken for for this particle to go from point A to B and then return back to point A. Okay, so let's write this as T1. Okay, for first collision, this much time it will take. So for ith collision also we can write, like we wrote the velocity in the similar fashion. So similarly, we can also write ith collision the time of flight is ti, and that will be equal to 2 times of ui by g. Okay, now the total time for the ball to come to rest, how can we write that? So first let's write the statement, total time will be, so this will be the summation of all the times of flight, right? So this will be summation, so sum of all the time of flight. Okay, so T will be equal to, so let's write capital T for this, total time for the ball to come to rest will be equal to, time taken for first collision is 2 times of u by g. U is the initial velocity, that is 4. So let's write here u1 plus 2 times of u2 by g. U2 is the time before second collision plus 2 u3 by g. U3 is the velocity before third collision, and it will go till infinity, right? Because if you observe in this diagram, if you calculate the next velocity or the ui plus 1 velocity, it will always be 0.8 times of the previous velocity. Okay, so it will never come to zero, so we cannot directly find any velocity on which the ball will come to rest. It's an infinite long process, that's why this series will run up to infinity. So infinite number of collisions are possible here. Now 2 by g is common in this, right, in this equation. So let's take 2 by g outside, and we know here this first term will be u1 plus u2 is 0.8 times of u1. So let's write here 0.8 times of u1 plus, now u3 is 0.8 times of u2, right? So this will be 0.8 times of u2, and u2 we know is 0.8 times of u1. So 0.8 into 0.8 times of u1 plus, similarly this is this, the next term will be 0.8 cube u1, because we are writing all the velocities in terms of u1. Okay, and it will run up to infinity, infinite number of terms. Okay, so from here now we can take u1 also outside. So 2 u1 value is already given in the problem, that is 4 meter per second whole divided by g, and the value of g we are taking is 10. So first term is 1 plus 0.8 plus 0.8 square plus 0.8 cube and so on up to infinity. Okay, so this will be the value of total time taken by the particle to come to rest, or by the point mass we can say. Now if we take a closer look here, we can see that this series is in GP, geometric progression, okay, with the common ratio r is 0.8 and the first term is 1. So we know to find the sum of GP, infinite number of terms of GP, as Sn is equal to a by 1 minus r. So this will be equal to a is 1 divided by 1 minus 0.8. So this will be equal to 1 by 0.2. So this is 5. Now we can find the total time taken. T will be equal to 2 into 4 by 10 multiplied by 5. So this will be equal to 4 seconds. okay, because we can 5 into 2 is 10. So this will be the total time taken by the point mass to come to rest after infinite number of collisions. Theoretically, actually infinite number of collisions. So option C is the correct choice. If you want to get more insight, you can refer to the NPTEL course, lecture number 6.1, Equation of Motions of a Rigid Body Dynamics on Mechanics of Solids by Professor M.S. Shivakumar of the Department of Applied Mechanics at IIT Madras.